cracked seam over here. You can see there's a split. I've already started to remove it, and I said, let me make a video on this so people could understand that there is this tool out there. This is called a all-way tool. So all I'm doing is putting this in there and it's cutting it. You see what I'm doing? Real easy to remove this, okay? Some things you're gonna need: paper towel, dish soap and water, garbage can, a wet cloth, and I also have a dry cloth, a vacuum near me. So we're removing this old caulk. Let me shine the light over here and show you guys how this is done. Okay. And all you do is put this edge of the tool in there, and you're easily removing this, where it could take hours with a razor blade. So that's how you remove it, and then I'm gonna show you guys how to caulk it.
Pretty much what you're doing is prepping the area, cleaning it, removing any dust or anything like that so you can get ready. Any loose debris is what you're doing. So anywhere where it's cracked, you're just gonna wanna remove it. If you could see that little line crack, get rid of it. So you could shove some new caulk in there. If you think it's fine, don't do it. But removing any cracks like that, it's nice to have a razor blade also handy to get up in there, because that tool is not gonna get everything. So entirely prep your area and remove any loose cracking. Also, what I picked up was Alex. Do not use 100% silicone. That's made for like bathrooms. So this one's like a $4 Alex. They do make a $2 Alex. This one says Alex Flex. If this is your home, I recommend a better one, a more expensive one. The more expensive one has like a 60-year. Make sure it's paintable. If it's not paintable, it's not what you want to use. So that way you could always paint it. This one says 60 years from cracking and all that. So what I did is I put a little slit on there, about a 45 degree angle. And if you're caulking, if nobody's ever caulked before, you do have to use your finger and dip it in soapy water. And then you glide your finger across it and shove it into the crack. Also, they do make, if you do find this tool, I'm sure you can Google it and find it, the all-way tool, A-L-L-W-A-Y. It has these edges on here where you can dip this in like soapy water and then just push it up in there with one of these corners. There's three different sizes. You can flip this if you want to use a different size, but the one that I'm using is the one that I like. So I usually use my finger most of the time, so, but it is handy for you beginners. I'm gonna zoom in over here so you guys can see a better look at it. Clean any loose debris like that. And I'm just gonna caulk this for you guys so you guys can get an idea of what's going on. I got everything removed that I want in this area. The rest of the door from up above here is fine. And now I'm just gonna take my caulk gun and I'm gonna aim it at a 45 degree angle. I'm gonna shove this into that crack and put a bead on there. Probably need a little bit more right here. The hole is a little bit deeper. And a little bit right here. And over here, I'm gonna aim it at 45. Squirt it in. Also there. Just gonna do this corner for you guys. You can see how nice it looks. All right, so I got that all squirted. Need some right here. Okay. Let's see if I'm zoomed in. Yeah, I'm zoomed in pretty good for you guys. I'm gonna take my finger and I'm gonna do that. A little bit too much coming there. Have your paper towel that you had, wipe it. Then you can dip your hand in that soapy water after you've ran your finger on it. Don't do it before because you cannot get it to bond against the wall. You run your finger first, and then the soapy water comes after, because that soapy water, if that gets on the surface, it will not bond anymore, and you'll have to wait until that's dry to start again. So make sure that you run your finger first. And just smooth it out and play with it to get it to keep that shape. I'm gonna throw my paper towel and get a new one. A It's nice to have a flashlight shining at it so you can really see what's going on, especially if it's dark or the sun's not out. And this will save you a lot of money on your energy bill, because little cracks like that, if you add up all the little cracks, you'll have a giant hole in your house just letting cold air in. And this is paintable, and that's what's nice. If you can fill in little cracks with it, and that's great. You don't have to like tape it and stuff like that. I have a hairline crack here. I don't know if you guys can see it. And I'm just shoving this into the crack, which will stop that from cracking. You can use it as a filler for anything. So instead of drywall compound, a lot stronger this Alex stuff is. All right, so that's pretty much this corner here is pretty much perfect. And I'm gonna zoom in to show you guys what has happened to this area. Not too hard. Once you get experienced at it, you get better and better and be able to move a lot quicker. So I'm just gonna zoom in and show you guys how that looks now. And it just needs to be painted and it'll look good as new. All right, so thanks for watching. Hopefully you learned something here. And give me a thumbs up, that's all I ask.